we start with 201, 1 over 7, over 8. And we know that 201, 1 over 7 can be written at 200 plus 1 plus 1 over 7 divided by 8. If you have this, it means that this is 200 plus 8 over 7. If you divide by 8, and it means that 200 divided by 8, you have 25. 8 over 7 divided by 8, you have 1 over 7. And it's given that this is A plus 1 over 7, and therefore A equals to 25. And we solve the first question. I'll show you another method for this question. Given this equation is true, what we can do is we can multiply everything with 8. So it means that if this multiply with 8, I have 201 and 1 over 8. If I multiply this with 8, I have 8a. And this is 8 over 7. Now note that 201 and 1 over 7 can be written at 200 plus 8 over 7. And this means that 200 is equal to 8a, and therefore a equals to 25. From the question, we know that 3 marks contributes 5%. So in order to get 100%, we need to just multiply by 20. So 6 times 20, and you have this is 60 marks. And we are done. So the total marks for the English test is 60. So here is question number 3. So we can start drawing a square. And from this square, we know that this is E. And the side length is 8. Okay. Right. After that, we can have a line that is parallel to the vertical line here. Now, note that this one, this triangle, if we have some line that is parallel to this and touch this here, then we can conclude that the area of this triangle is equal to area of this triangle. And in fact, it's also an area of that triangle. They are all the same because they have the same base and the same height. So now we can transform this into a point inside the square. So I can just transform this somewhere here. And they are still of the same area. Now, it is obvious that this small triangle here is same as the area will be the same. So these two areas the same, and these two areas the same. And we know that the whole square is of area 64 according to the question. It means that the area of the shape region will be half of the area of a square. It means that the area of shaded region is equal to half of the area of the square, meaning that this is 32, and we are done. So we need to observe the pattern. So what we have is that for a whole number, is either odd or even. For this sequence, it starts with 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, but we write 3 and 1, 4, 5, and so on and so forth. Now, so this number is actually an odd number followed by even number. After that is an odd number, even number, then odd number, even number, and this pattern will continue. And we see that for each of this, each three of this, you have two odd and one even. Two odd and one even. Two odd and one even. So this pattern will continue and until the last two digit. Okay, so this is the 199 numbers and this is the 200 digit. And it will be 00. If we include 201 here, it will be even number. Okay, so the total number is equals to 2 over 3, 201. And if you cancel this, you will have this is 6, and this will be 21, so it's 7. So I will have 1, 4, 1, 3, 4 odd number in the first 200 numbers. One simpler way is we can just list out all the possible value of A, B, and C. So I say this is A, B, and C. I start with 24, and this is 1. If this is 1, this will be 52. And in this case, A times A plus C, this is equals to 76. Now we can have, if this is 2, then this will be equals to 12. And A times B times C equals to 52, this will be equals to 26. Now what we have here is this is 38. Now we can see from here that when B increase, A plus C will be decreasing. Is this true for the rest? Let's try. If this is 3, then this will be equal to 8. If B is 3, there's no such C. So it's not possible. When B is 4, you will have this is equal to 6. And when B is 4, this will equal to 1, 3, and you have 19. Okay? And what other possible value for B? B can be 6. For each of these value, there's no such C exists. C is not an integer. So among of the value of A plus C, 19 is the minimum.